Welcome to another episode of the Azure Enablement Show. Today, we are going to talk about the Microsoft Cloud Adoption Framework Landing Zone Review. And if you have watched that video, check out the links and resources below so you can learn more and try out the assessment yourself. And then if you have questions or comments, feel free to comment below and also make sure you subscribe to the channel to not miss any episodes. Welcome back. My name is Thomas Maurer, and I'm excited to meet Dom and Jeff today to talk about the Azure Landing Zone reviews. And Azure Landing Zones are obviously a very interesting concept where we have customers go to Azure, but they can be challenging for customers who have already started or they're just thinking about starting because we have different options depending on where you are, and we're going to make this easier today. But Dom, before we actually dive into this, can you explain us what Azure Landing Zones are?
Sure, let's take a look. So an Azure Landing Zone is the foundation for a successful cloud environment. As part of the Cloud Adoption Framework journey, it's the first technical step, and it's a crucial set of considerations and decisions that help you build an Azure environment that will scale with your business.
No, that's fantastic. But customers are usually often like in different states, right? We have customers who are probably just getting started, so they can have really a greenfield approach. But then we have customers, they already working with Azure, and they already have resources deployed in Azure. Can they use that too?
So we kind of think about it in three core customer types when we talk about where they are on their journey. To start with, we have Start, which is that greenfield type of customer where they're beginning their journey, they don't have an Azure environment today, and they want to take all of that best practice and our conceptual architecture as part of their journey into the cloud. The second is a brownfield customer where they have some cloud resources running something in Azure, and they want to align to our best practices and our conceptual architecture. So we give them guidance on how to take what they've currently got and align to how we see an Azure Landing Zone. The third is where a customer has a well-designed, well-implemented environment, but they want to add specific elements to it, for example, security or governance. And we look at those as an enhanced type of customer, and we provide guidance for those as well.
Well, that's great. So Dom, wherever customers are in their cloud journey, if they just getting started, if they need to align, or if they need to enhance their landing zone, we can actually help them. And so it's really for everyone. But Dom, if I'm now want to implement this, if I'm thinking about I'm an engineer or a cloud architect, how do I think about the Azure Landing Zone requirements? What are the requirements for that?
So if we take a look at this, we kind of group the considerations and the decisions you need to make when you build your landing zone into what we call our design areas. And we split those into two core groups, the environment and the compliance. So for the environment decisions, these are the elements that you really need to get right first time. Things like your Active Directory tenant, your identity and access management model, how you're going to organize your resources, and the network design and connectivity you want. Alongside those, we have the compliance elements, security, governance, management, and platform automation and DevOps. And these are the elements that are likely to mature and you're going to iterate on over time as your organization grows and as the skills inside your organization grow as well.
Thank you very much, Dom. So this is awesome. So obviously we have all these guidance for customers, but we also want to make it easy for customers to actually implement that guidance. And so that is where I want to talk with Jeff. About the Azure Landing Zone review assessments. So Jeff, can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, of course, Thomas. You know, the assessments are meant to help customers understand the investments that they've made today and where they would want to further invest in their landing zone design. Maybe they need more scalability, maybe they need more modularity in how they're investing in their resource management groups and their resources or subscriptions. We really want to provide that guidance for customers who already have a landing zone and are looking for where they need to invest across the design areas next. So the review assessment helps them understand where they are in alignment to the Azure Landing Zone conceptual architecture and what recommendations we suggest that they put in place to be in further alignment.
Okay, now this is awesome. This definitely helps customers by implementing and operationalizing Azure Landing Zones in their environment. Can you show us a little bit how that works and how we can use that assessment?
Sure. So first thing I did is here is I went to aka.ms/assessments, right? So this is our assessments site. And right here I have Azure Landing Zone Review. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on that Azure Landing Zone review to start my assessment, right? First thing is the name for my assessment. I'm going to stick with the default name. You'll also see that you'll get added by default the date and the time in there. So as we go through this assessment process, I want to capture where our company is currently making investments across these design areas. So I'm just going to select Azure Billing and Active Directory. I've got some concerns in my organization today around how we're handling billing and what recommendations align best to the guidance that's in the Azure Billing and Active Directory design area. And then also governance is a big topic. So I'll take those two and I'll go ahead and click start. And from here, I'm going to start to tell the assessment about my organization. So the first question here is, how do we describe our current Azure environment? Well, the Azure environment for my organization is that we have some we have a tenant in place and we have a single subscription, no management groups in place. So I'll go ahead and select that. Next, I'll tell the assessment a little bit about my team, how we organize. We happen to be a centralized operation cloud operating model. So our cloud operating model is such that our core development team works on the platform as well as the application side. So they have responsibilities for both the foundational utilities of the landing zone, those shared services, as well as the workloads themselves. Once I've done that, I'll go ahead and click next in my assessment. And then I've got this question around, what are my capabilities when it comes to infrastructure as code? Again, informing the assessment about where our organization lies today. We've got some strength in GitHub as well as HashiCorp Terraform and on Azure Bicep. So once I've got those selected, I'll go ahead and click next. And now I'm into the Azure Billing and Active Directory section of the assessment. We have an enterprise agreement, so I'll go ahead and select that. And then the next question here is about my identity infrastructure. We are trying to understand whether we've made investments with other cloud services like Office 365. And in my example for my organization, we do have integration with, we have on-premise Active Directory domain services, and we have integrated that with Azure Active Directory through Azure AD Connect. So I'll go ahead and select that option. And then the question here is around, what type of features do I require for my organization when it comes to operating with infrastructure as code? So I would like to use IDE, my application and platform management tools, as well as a Microsoft 365 developer subscription, because we do a lot across the Microsoft platform and cloud. So on my governance design area here, I'm asked about how we track costs with our resources. We do that with all of our workloads. And then I've got a question here around my tagging of my resources. Currently today, we don't tag our Azure resources with metadata that helps us identify them, as well as this next question is about how we optimize our spending with Azure utilizing Azure Advisor. And we're just learning how to do that. Now, once I fill in that last question, I'll be kicked over to my guidance and my results. And there's a couple of things I want to call out here with this guidance and results as we talk about those best practices, those tips. The first thing is that all of my results are put together into a score. So I can see my score here is 17 points out of 35, as well as I can see where I land with the design areas that I filled out questions for. I'm doing rather well in Azure Billing and Active Directory. I'm okay about my organization. Probably need to make some improvements there as well as on governance. If I continue to scroll down, I'll see some actions that are called out here for going through and preparing the environment, deploying the Azure Landing Zone Accelerator, and then maybe I need to connect with a partner. Through that, I can continue to scroll down to my results. And so this is where I can actually see those recommendations, Thomas, that we talked about. And so this is where it's key to really understand, like for example, with governance, I've got some, so I need to put some tagging in place for my resources. I need to track costs across my business units. And when I click on these recommendations, I'll be sent to those specific action items that I can put into my environment. Now here's where the tips click in, right? So I've got the results, right? So first thing is I can go up to the top of the assessments platform and I can export this as a CSV. This is, you know, you can imagine this is used for probably a number of things. I would say maybe I'm going to import this into my Azure DevOps backlog and we're going to work off of this as a team. Now, so that's a great feature, a great tip to see customers use. The other thing is the answer summary. Sometimes the question doesn't help you, or the answer doesn't help you understand the question that you were asked. So in the answer summary, you can not only see the question that you were asked, but the answer that you responded to. And this comes to do with kind of tracking as you use the assessment platform. And that's the last tip that I'd like to say, is that even though you fill out an assessment once, it doesn't mean that that has to be your final time filling out this assessment. So I've gone ahead in the background and I filled out this assessment with every design area. You can see I've got 111 points out of 243. You can look at the design areas where I've invested in. I've got some excellent, I've got some that are moderate, some that are critical. So I can see that there are investments that I need to make across my design areas. Again, I've got the results down below. But what I want to point out here is that I can go through and start a new assessment on the assessment platform. So I'll go through and start my Azure Landing Zone assessment. Again, just to show you this feature that I can create a milestone. So in that same assessment where maybe I might have scored 50 or 60 points, I can go ahead and create a milestone, go through that assessment again, update my answers because now we put some of those recommendations in place and see the improvements that we made over time. Those tips, you know, and how people are using the assessment, we've seen a lot of feedback from our customers and our partners that it helps solidify their journey and the next steps that they should take with Azure Landing Zone.
Oh, this is fantastic. And again, I'm blown away because we're taking all the power and knowledge we have in the cloud adoption framework for Azure Landing Zones, and we building this tool, this assessment tool, to make it super easy for people to identify gaps and what they need to work on and see what they can actually do. I really love it. So if I'm now a customer and I actually want to learn more about this, or maybe also go out and take this assessment, where do I go?
Go and check out aka.ms/assessments, and you'll be going through the Azure Landing Zone review.
Thank you very much, Dom. Thank you very much, Jeff. It was great having you. And thank you very much, everyone watching. Make sure you check out aka.ms/adopt.